This battle has now turned its heat onto the state which sends maximum members to the parliament. With the political dust storm picking up, we've known that enterprising Gujaratis have proved their mettle of business across the world. But politics now has pitchforked two Gujaratis into the world's biggest electoral battlefield.
Amit Shah is as controversial as his mentor, the Gujarat Chief Minister. Currently out on bail in cases pertaining to Sohrabuddin fake encounter case, Shah began a very important innings of his political career on June 12. The General Secretary of the BJP made his first visit to Uttar Pradesh after being appointed as the state's in charge. The abilities of the man known for his organizational skills and grassroots networking with workers will be severely tested in a state which will make or break Modi's prime ministerial ambitions.
If Uttar Pradesh is with us, which people in Uttar Pradesh are responding very positively to the BJP, and people say now out of 80 seats, almost more than half the seats have a positive inclination to the BJP, we have another 1 year to go for the elections. And if this succeeds, it's a miracle. And the miracle is based out of Mr. Narendra Modi's aura of taking along the party, taking along the workers. And Amit Shah is of course, the torchbearer for that.
UP and Bihar, both are going to be very critical for both the Congress and the BJP. Now, the BJP, after its loss in Karnataka, is really virtually out of the South. So, weak in the South, weak in the East. West Bengal, Bihar remains to be seen, Odisha. So where will they up their numbers? It is these two large states of the Ganga Belt, which is UP and Bihar. It is going to be a mother of all battles, Uttar Pradesh in 2014.
In UP, Rahul's home turf, the battle is also between two key aides of the two leaders. Amit Shah is pitted against Madhusudan Mistry.
This is really where you're going to see the Rahul versus Narendra Modi face-off by proxy, through, you know, their representatives. In UP, we have two clear representatives now, Madhusudan Mistry for the Congress and Amit Shah for the BJP. Amit Shah comes from Gujarat. He knows his Gujarat. He's, you know, born, bred there. He was active in student politics. UP is a completely different ball game. You know, the states are different in every which way. I mean, the whole caste equations, the social equations, the communities has a very large Muslim population. And it's a very kind of laid back, kind of, you know, sort of state. And I think the same goes for Madhusudan Mistry. Very impressive credentials, you know, in the NGO field. He runs several NGOs in Gujarat. He's worked with tribals. He's been active on the trade union front. But, you know, they don't have the experience in UP.
If the former is buoyed by the hopes of turning his mentor, the PM, Mistry has to justify the trust Rahul Gandhi has accorded him against the wishes of many.
For Narendra Modi to become a serious player, he will have to really do well in these two states. And he wanted Amit Shah as his trusted person to be made in charge in Uttar Pradesh, and he had his way because he would like to decide the tickets, he would like to be in control in Uttar Pradesh. On the other side, Rahul has put Madhusudan Mistry, who's emerged as his confidant in the party in UP. And it will be a battleground between two Gujaratis, ironically, in the country's largest state.
And they've been parachuted into this complex, diverse, popular state on the eve of the elections. Whether they have the time to really set up that organizational machinery that is necessary to fight such a difficult election, I don't know. You see, Gujarat, again, it's a bipolar state. It's Congress versus, you know, BJP, right? UP, you've got two very strong, dominant regional parties, the SP and the BSP, and their leaders, Mulayam Singh Yadav and Mayawati, they know UP like the back of their hands. They really know their UP politics. So I think it's a formidable task for both the Congress and the BJP.
While Mistry, said to have strong understanding of grassroots politics, replaced Digvijay Singh after leading the Congress to a big victory in Karnataka. Narendra Modi's commander has won his assembly seat four times and also hailed for working behind Modi's consecutive victories in Gujarat.
Amit Shah in Uttar Pradesh is a facilitator for the larger cause of the Bharatiya Janata Party, and of course he would be seen. I could not say he is seen, but he could be seen as a face of Narendra Modi.
So you are not deterred by Madhusudan Mistry there?
If he could not match Narendra Modi or Amit Shah in Gujarat, Mr. Madhusudan Mistry, what could he do in Uttar Pradesh is a big question.
This heartland state with 80 Lok Sabha seats is crucial for both the national parties and the challenge from regional players in their fight for the centre. While Rahul is personally keeping a close eye, BJP is hopeful that its poster boy's polarising effect will fill its kitty enough to consolidate its march to the parliament.
From the brains behind those closed doors and the bronze out on the dust and heat of the field, Team Rahul and Team Modi are on their quest to find for that winning formula.
The goal is set, the battlefront identified. The generals geared up. Both the commanders-in-chief playing their part in relocating the pieces of the political chessboard. It's time for checkmate.